Thank you for being here.
Reconciliation. If I am to understand it correctly, if it means that this perpetrator, this man who has killed Christopher Pete, if it means that he becomes human again, this man, then it means that so will I become human. So will all of us get our humanity back. Then I agree. I support it all. Thank you.
Molweni. Huyenant. Faithful one of the ages, you send your rain upon the good and the evil. You set your sun to shine upon the just and the unjust. This is your way of overcoming evil with good, of turning injustice into justice. Make your way become our way. Replace our thirst for national competition with a passion for human cooperation. Take our prayers for greatness and turn them into prayers for goodness. Take our desires for success and turn them into commitment for service. Grant us the vision of a world at peace, the desire to see that world in our lifetime, and the courage to seek it now. You gave us an abundant harvest to feed the hungry, but people still die of starvation. You gave us advanced cultures to spread the joy of learning, but people still wallow in ignorance. You gave us technology to enhance the quality of life, but people are still living in misery. You gave us the gift of democracy to model the virtues of freedom, but people still have reason to doubt our practice of the freedom we proclaim. We ask your forgiveness for our failure of memory and courage. Refresh our memory and renew our courage that we might reveal the source of our gifts by the way we use them. Let us dedicate our bounty to the war on poverty, our learning to the war on ignorance, our technology to the war on misery, our democracy to the war on oppression. Let us intercede for all victims of injustice with our deeds as with our words. Guardian of our memories and our hopes, help us to know the greatness of your power resting within us and to use it so that we may never forget the good that you would have us do and be, and so that hope for a new life in a new world may be accomplished through us. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Everything I know, and it also goes for everything I don't know about theology, I learned from Archbishop Tutu. My professor of theology in university, so if anything, you can blame on him on that score.
Thank you very much. Ambassador Sisulu, Your Royal Highness, distinguished representatives of state, ladies and gentlemen and friends, it is indeed a privilege and honor for me to be a part of this evening's celebration. Desmond Tutu, it was in the home of a Jew, and had longed to meet him, and I was pleased and flattered at the fact that he said he too longed to meet me. It was a rather tender and precious moment. What I had in mind was very simple. I just wanted to meet him. What he had in mind, however, was... to reintroduce slavery by forcing those of us who were innocent and willing to forever be in his service, doing some of the most grueling, yet some of the most rewarding work. It was indeed, for me, another blessing. Peace has always been central to my existence. It has always been an opportunity to share in a life that was filled with purpose and filled with honor. Now that the foundation has been established here and is launched for the first time in America, I'm sure that the Archbishop knows that those of us who stand strong will be in the service of the mission. I thank him for his guidance. I thank him for his commitment and his courage and his display of humanity. It has touched many of us profoundly. And those of us who know that there is still much to be done, greet that task eagerly, because we know that in the journey itself, we will be touching the lives of fellow human beings who are rich and who are purposeful and who will make our lives much the better for the journey. So, Archbishop, I thank you. I was with some children today, and one young man said to me, he says, you're going to a peace rally? I said, well, you can call it a rally. Archbishop Desmond Tutu is there, it'll probably be a rally. But I'm going because there are not enough peace institutions in the world.
Here.
Obviously, if there were, then the wars that are everywhere would no longer exist. We would all be in harmony with one another. There'd be no racism, no sexism, etc., etc., etc. And while I don't really know what lies at the end of the road, I do know that in the journey, people like Archbishop Desmond Tutu, it will be an honorable march. And I'm glad to have been given the privilege to take that journey. I am older than the Archbishop is, but that does not command much respect. When you are a slave, you do as the master commands. But I serve willingly, and I hope that the years that are left to us will be filled with exchanges that will help benefit our souls and benefit all of humankind. Thank you very, very much.
But the question is now simply, what comes next for South Africa? And the Desmond Tutu Peace Center is part of the answer. The center will continue your work. It will ensure not only that the history of the past 25 years will never be forgotten, but also that the next chapter of history of South Africa and of Southern Africa in general will continue to be about the triumph of hope, of freedom, and of the human spirit. It is to support the work of the Desmond Tutu Peace Center, and it will be made to the Desmond Tutu Foundation. In closing, I just want to thank you, Your Grace, for all that you've done and continue to do to help keep the flame of hope alive in the hearts of people everywhere who believe in and love Africa the way you and I do.
Very, very, very dear friends, what can I say? That was said by a preacher who had gone on for too long. What more can I say? And somebody in the back said, Amen. I must tell you, I am a snob. I am a snob, and I am great at dropping memes. I do it quite nonchalantly, you know. when I had lunch with Princess Irene, just as I said to Madiba, you know. And well, yes, when I was in the Oval Office, I certainly... Somebody was telling a lovely story about a friend of his who was an inveterate name dropper, and he said, "Jack, just tell me, why do you like dropping names in the fashion that you do?" And Jack said, "You know, that's strange, because yesterday when I was in Buckingham Palace..." Sheila, thank you very much. I mean, Your Excellency. Thank you for your kind words. I was actually going to be saying that I am basking in reflected glory as I see you go from one pinnacle to a higher. It's wonderful to be able to say to people, I did try to teach her a bit of theology, and I was a chaplain. Salim, thank you for your part in representing our country so splendidly well. And there can be no doubt at all about your commitment and your willpower, because anyone who knew you before today will say, look at your wonderful figure. I mean, and we know that you are going to be just wonderful, wonderful in whatever you may be going to be doing next time round. Thank you, Princess Irene. We gave her a Xhosa name, which is really a translation of Greek name, and said she's Unoxolo. The bringer of peace. She is president of something called World in Harmony. It's an organization that takes surpluses from the affluent West and matches them with needs in other parts. Like if there are too many cows in Spain, then they cull them by taking them to India. Actually, a wonderful thing. And she's got a very, very soft spot for Robben Island. She has planted a tree outside the Church of the Good Shepherd on Robben Island. And she's just a tremendous, tremendous person. Thank you. Yes, you will have to be on the board. it's not fair. I mean, you know, you have heard him sing.
No.
Harry. It can't be that you would come here. And you speak quite well, but I think...
Being that I believe in community spirit, I think it is only befitting that I will sing a few short bars of a song I wrote this morning. And that after each line that I sing, those gathered here will repeat after me exactly what I say.